Robert Payne pursued a variety of professions during his life, beginning as a teacher and retiring as a judge from the Massachusetts Supreme Court. He was also a chaplain, lawyer, representative to the Provincial Congress, Massachusetts delegate to the Continental Congress, and the founder of the American Academy of Arts and Sciences. Robert Payne's formal education included studies leading to teaching theology and law. Payne attended the Boston Latin School until he was 14. Then he entered Harvard. After 4 years of study, he was graduated as a qualified teacher. While Payne taught school, his parents exerted pressure on him to become a minister. As a result, he continued his studies at Harvard in theology. His father, a Boston merchant, had originally been a minister. While Robert Payne was teaching and studying, he became quite ill. In order to relax and regain his health, he traveled to Spain, the Azores, England, Greenland, and the southern colonies. Payne's one experience as a minister was in 1755 as the acting chaplain on a military expedition to Crown Point, New York. However, before he completed his theological studies, Robert Payne decided to become a lawyer and started studying law. In 1757, Payne was admitted to the Massachusetts bar. Payne's professional career began in Portland, Maine, which was then a part of Massachusetts where he practiced law. 4 years later, he moved to Taunton, Massachusetts, where he met and married Sally Cobb, the daughter of General David Cobb, the lieutenant governor of Massachusetts colony. Even though Payne was one of the earliest supporters of independence, he maintained the crown-appointed governor's respect for a long time, possibly a result of his relationship with the lieutenant governor. Robert Payne served the people of Massachusetts as Taunton's representative to the Provincial Congress and as a delegate to the Continental Congress. The governor dismissed the Massachusetts Assembly in 1768. Assemblymen and other influential citizens established a Provincial Congress to handle the affairs of the Massachusetts colony. Robert Payne was selected by Taunton to be its representative in the Provincial Congress. In 1770, Payne was also the prosecuting attorney in a case involving British soldiers accused of murdering civilians in what has been called the Boston Massacre. John Adams defended Captain Preston and his men. The jury found two of the soldiers guilty of manslaughter. Payne also represented Taunton in the Massachusetts General Court from 1773 to 1775. An early advocate of independence, Payne served the people of Massachusetts in a variety of ways. He was on the committee which asked for a Continental Congress to be convened. In 1773, he was chairman of the Taunton Committee of Vigilance. In 1774, he was involved with the impeachment of Chief Justice Oliver of the British Court. Oliver was accused of acting for the Crown instead of the Provincial Assembly. Since Chief Justice Oliver's salary was paid by the British Crown, the claim was substantiated, and he was impeached. The Provincial Assembly was very divided on the question of participation in the Continental Congress. The original Continental Congress was called to solve the problems caused by overtaxation and non-representation in England. It was not called to bring about separation from England. Following a particularly effective speech by Robert Payne, the vote was taken on whether or not to send delegates to the Continental Congress. Payne sent one opposition man on an errand at the time the vote was taken, and by a majority of one vote, the Provincial Congress decided to send a delegation to the Continental Congress. In the Congress, Robert Payne served on the Committee of Arms and the Army. At one point in the debates, Payne said, "I fear we shall become slaves because we are not industrious enough to be free." Dr. Rush described Payne as a firm, decided, and persevering patriot, and eminently useful in Congress, particularly on committees in which he was remarkable for his regular and punctual attendance. His temper was amiable, his speeches and conversations often facetious. had a certain obliquity of understanding which prevented his seeing public objects in the same light in which they were seen by other people. He seldom proposed anything, but opposed nearly every measure proposed by other people, and hence got the name of objection maker in Congress. Robert Payne had hopes for reconciliation with the British. In his early speeches, he advocated that objective. After his hopes were smashed in the Battle of Bunker Hill in June of 1775, he became a very active member of the Committee of the Army, obtaining bayonets, guns, and gunpowder. Robert Payne's career advanced from representative to justice after the signing of the Declaration of Independence. Payne stayed in Congress until 1778, and at the same time served in the Massachusetts House of Representatives as the Speaker of the House. He worked on a committee which lowered the price of labor and goods to a standard of equality in Massachusetts known as the Regulatory Act. He was elected unanimously by both legislative houses to serve as Massachusetts Attorney General from 1777 to 1790. Payne helped draft the Massachusetts State Constitution and served on the council, which was the upper house of the legislature. Payne moved to Boston and founded the American Academy of Arts and Sciences in 1780. He was offered a judgeship on the Massachusetts Supreme Court in 1783, but he remained the Attorney General, favoring the higher pay of the job. In 1790, the court position was again offered to him, and he accepted. Robert Payne retired from the court at age 73 due to deafness and the travel demands of being a justice. Even though he and his wife Sally had 8 children, Payne's responsibility always seemed to be elsewhere. He was the thin-lipped Puritan who showed little mercy on those who didn't meet his expectations. His son was a poet and married an actress, contrary to Robert Payne's wishes. As a result, Robert Payne completely cut himself off from his son. Payne was arrested once for traveling on Sunday, and another time was fined in Crossroads Court for violating a law which he had earlier written. In his later years, Robert Payne remained intellectually and politically active. Robert Payne left the Calvinist tradition and joined the Unitarian Church. He was a Federalist who supported Washington and John Adams and had considerable influence during their administrations. 10 years after his retirement from the court, Robert Payne died at age 83. His son became a very respected poet, and his great-grandson, Robert T. Payne, became a well-known businessman philanthropist.